Okay. If a servant of the Lord who in ordinary days is healthy and lives comfortably with adequate sleep and nutrition cannot exercise authority over his body in time of need, he is useless to God. So we read 1 Corinthians 9:27, which says, I buffet my body and bring it into bondage, Paul declared. Lest be any means after that I have preached to others, and I myself should be rejected or disqualified. In other words, he was fearful that having preached the gospel to others, he himself should fail to receive the reward of hearing the Lord say, quote, good and well done, my servant, unquote. That has nothing to do with losing eternal life. The same principle applies to all the other verses Craig mentions that only apparently or seem like a person can lose salvation. That's what Arminius says. He said there's verses that seem like a person could lose eternal life, but he said, I've never ever said that they actually could. And I understand what he's saying there. He's saying that I agree there's some passages that can be difficult, but when you pray upon them and pray, you can see how it's quite easy to see how all the scriptures come alive so beautifully that we're talking about rewards and loss of rewards, or we're talking other times about a person coming so close to God, it was better that he never even came close to God because his hell is going to be worse than the hell that an atheist and a Muslim is going to go through because they have less knowledge of God's saving grace, right? I have an argument here to say that Craig's hell is going to be worse than the hell of a lot of these other people because he's come so close to God and he's still preaching a false gospel. Shame on him. You think he's just going to lose rewards? I don't think so. I don't even think he's born again. That is amazing. All right. So, what seems to be true is only apparent. In reality, God is warning Christians not to fall away. Not because they can fall away all the way, for that is impossible, but they can fall away partially. Just like depravity is partial, not total. Everybody's a totalist these days. Okay. There is another group of passages out there, not the ones Craig presented in Lest Anyone Should Fall Away, his famous article or essay, which indicates individuals who had come so close to God yet drew back. They too fell away, though not in the same way. Two kinds of fallings away. You can fall away to lose rewards, but you can also fall away from coming so close to God. They draw back onto perdition, quote unquote. Hebrews 10:39. Jeez, that's one of my favorite verses actually. And a careful studies of Hebrews 6:1-8 shows us that they cannot lose salvation, but they can certainly be disciplined and lose rewards. And the best writer on Hebrews 6:1-8 is Watchman Nee. What he said on those verses are absolutely incredible. Incredibly accurate. Totally proves you cannot lose salvation. That's not what these verses are saying. You cannot lose salvation. You cannot lose salvation. Talking about discipline and punishment. I'll talk about that in a bit. And I'll quote some of Nee on that. Watchman Nee. With white covers from Christian Fellowship publishers. And not the Watchman he presented by Living Stream Ministries, which is a cult, I should say. I do not want to get into that. The next thing I wanted to say, William Craig makes the common error, though he bears false witness against Jacob Arminius. I've already mentioned that. Because he said the Arminian perspective teaches, quote, he actually said this, the individual salvation is contingent on your faith and can be lost, unquote, in his Defenders podcast series, number 11, in the Doctrine of Salvation. Craig admits in his false view of Arminians being non-OSAS, quote, however, we interpret these passages, I think the Arminius are quite right. These warnings were certainly written to Christians. There is no way you can think these are unbelievers that are recipients of these passages, unquote. Now remember, Craig's taken all those passages one way. Calvinists will take them all the other way. I am saying that there's the middle position where some verses mean this, some verses mean that. However, just because they are written to believers is not the reason to think they can lose eternal life. Craig admits, quote, "When you look at the warnings, I think they indicate the Arminian." I'm giving away my own views, he says. Obviously, he says. And he says, "I think they do indicate a real possibility of believers falling away." He's meaning all the way. "That this is something that is a real possibility for the Christian," unquote. Just like Calvinists have hijacked the Reformation of justification by faith and turned it into predestination by irresistible grace and not sufficient grace for all to have the choice, many non-OSASers have hijacked Arminius. For Arminius said, never once did he teach a person can lose salvation. For example, the Remonstrants changed Arminianism to non-OSAS. It's crazy, I know. Anyway, Jacob Arminius got it right. Others that get it right are Watchman Nee, Dave Hunt, Jesse Pan Lewis, I believe Lee Strobel, I had thought William Lane Craig, but now I know William Lane Craig is wrong. It's only because after reading some of this stuff and keep reading some of this stuff, I couldn't get him to actually make a definite statement, but I got him to make a definite statement on his Defenders podcast, so there's no issue about it. Now, even when you heard him say reluctantly that he was a Wesleyan, you still couldn't be quite sure whether he was non-OSAS, because he could have just been taking the 4 points of Wesley and leaving it in question whether or not he was an OSAS Arminian. So we should pray for William Lane Craig to stop bearing false witness against Jacob Arminius. That's very important. The non-OSASer will try verses like Colossians 1:2-3. This is the King James Version. If ye continue in the faith grounded and settled, and be not moved away from the hope of the gospel, which ye have heard, and which was preached to every creature which is under heaven, whereof I, Paul, am made a minister. Now, the non-OSASer will say, if is a condition to continue in the faith. But read this verse carefully. It says you can have a heart of unbelief. This is the doubt many Christians undergo. But it is not a falling away. Away. Moving away from the hope is not a falling away. Away. It's just a directional movement. That's all it's saying. Hebrews 3:12 says, take heed, brethren, lest there be any of you an evil heart of unbelief in departing from the living God. To depart from the living God for a Christian is not the removal of the indwelling Holy Spirit, but removal of his infilling. Eternal life is eternal. In order for these verses to clearly teach a person can lose eternal life and after receiving it at new birth, he would have to state it in no uncertain terms. Now, I'm not, sometimes I can make a mistake in reading these scriptures too. Sometimes I may take a verse inadvertently referring to someone who's saved, who doesn't lose eternal life, but falls away, but not all the way. Without, sometimes could have actually originally intended to have meant the person couldn't, that actually never actually came to Christ, was never actually saved. They came so close, but then drew away. And I think it's possible sometimes I could have made a mistake in doing that. Maybe I was rushed in reading it or whatnot, because I'm holding to my position and missing that verse. But I still think that is still the correct way to interpret these verses that we're trying to splice, which way or the other.